external ear anatomy. Today, we are going to learn about anatomy of external ear. The ear is divided into three parts. 1. External ear. 2. Middle ear. 3. Internal ear. The external ear is again divided into three parts, which will make it easier to remember. Its three parts are 1. Auricle or pinna. 2. External acoustic canal. And 3. The tympanic membrane. 1. Auricle or pinna. The entire pinna, except its lobule, which is made of fat, and the outer part of external acoustic ear canal, are made up of a framework of a single piece of yellow elastic cartilage, which is then covered with skin. There is no cartilage between the tragus and crus of the helix, and this area, which is without cartilage, is called the incisura terminalis. An incision made in this area will not cut through the cartilage, since cartilage are unable to heal properly, and therefore, this area is used for indural approach in surgery of the ear. Pinna is also the source of graft materials for the surgeon, cartilage from the tragus, perichondrium from the tragus or concha, and fat from the lobule are frequently used for reconstructive surgery of the middle ear. The conchal cartilage has also been used to correct the depressed nasal bridge, while the composite grafts of the skin and cartilage from the pinna are sometimes used for repair of defects of nasal alar in nasal surgery. 2. External acoustic auditory canal. It extends from the bottom of the concha to the tympanic membrane and measures about 24 millimeters along its posterior wall. It is not a straight tube. Its outer part is directed upwards, backwards, and medially, while its inner part is directed downwards, forwards, and medially. Therefore, to see the tympanic membrane, the pinna has to be pulled upwards, backwards, and laterally, so as to bring the two parts in alignment. The canal is divided into two parts, A. cartilaginous, and B. bony. A. cartilaginous part. It forms outer one-third 8 millimeters of the canal. Cartilage is a continuation of the cartilage which forms the framework of the pinna. B. bony part. It forms inner two-thirds, 16 millimeters. 3. Tympanic membrane or the drumhead. It forms the partition between the external acoustic canal and the middle ear. It is obliquely set and as a result, its posterosuperior part is more lateral than its anteroinferior part. It is 9 to 10 millimeters tall, 8 to 9 millimeters wide, and 0.1 millimeter thick. Tympanic membrane can be divided into two parts, pars tensa, pars flaccida.